Here we are, in the old part of Lahore, a city called Heart of Pakistan. These are the common scenes which I used to come across often in my streets. Why they look different from the women in my home, in my streets?
मेरा नाम एनी है। हम सिगरेट का स्टॉल लगाते हैं। हम द्रोने शहर मोची दरवाजा में पैदा हुए। हाँ, ये मेरा छोटा सा घर है, ये मेरा छोटा सा घर है, हम इसमें रहते हैं। ये देख लें, हमारा गरीब खान
मैं नहीं बिठाया।
क्यों नहीं बिठाया?
बस मैं कहता मैं नहीं बिठाना है। मैं अपने बाप ने कहता सी कि मेरा नाम ना बिठाना है। उस वेर में कहता मेरा नाम ना बिठाना ना मेरा गुरु। मैं कल्ला कल्ला फिर चेहरा पर बच्चा था, कल्ला कल्ला जवानी बचेरे आई है। आओ ना आओ ना, वो बड़े पावर लगे पता नहीं लगा, बड़े चावल लगे पता नहीं लगा।
There are so many people who Khusras. Okay, in India it's a very institutionalized activity. In Pakistan it's a very segmented, small communities living together. Like this informal, not
institutionalized, just elaborate.
Or like it's gharana and this kind of thing. In Pakistan, we don't have that kind of gharanas. There are so many variation in this community too. There are so many people who know that media is on them, and they have this sense what to sell. So they do this sellable thing to to the media. So it was very difficult to like screen those kind of people and really get closer to people who can express emotions, because this was my issue.
I think it's very, very, very beautifully portrayed. Mm, mm, mm. It's an amazing film, and it's left a very deep and profound, has had a deep impact on
It's such a delicate little thing.
Very. No?
The sensitivity comes across.
Absolutely.
Yeah, of the filmmaker,
yes.
You can see that.
But do you feel, Harit, that this is a beginning for you to actually start and delve deeper into, because on a very kind of, as a very big overview, I find that it's really beautiful because these are issues that exist, but are not visible to us.
Yeah.
And what you've done is you've kind of gone, done the research and made it visible.
Yeah.
What are your plans? Are you planning to kind of continue with unpicking these?
Of course, sure. I did a new research on a new subject, which is about matchmaking. We have this institution in Pakistan.
About what?
Matchmaking.
Oh, right.
Basically, I was thinking that already after watching the movie, it changed the perception of me about Khusro, and I think so everyone's. But I believe happy ending is not always the ending. But what was the message at the end? You didn't conclude it like there should be some happy ending or something.
Yeah, that's a conventional way of telling a story. So in this, we have a symbolic something. Which shows this seeking for love thing. Every human being seek love, and we leave it open for people to just get closer to it, and that's the mess.
I loved the fact that there were only two or three stories that we were following, and actually in the course of watching the entire piece, I felt really close to understanding who the people were who I was watching. I felt part of this story, and that's the power of this particular documentary, because in however short the focus has been, and it's a very limited focus, you get to really understand actually what the people have gone through and what they are going through being part of that society that we know as Pakistan from a distance, because it is the invisible stories that have been made visible, and that's the beauty of this documentary.
This film has traveled a lot around the world, like 14, 15 countries, and was premiered at Berlin Film Festival. So whenever I have I got the chance to present this film at festivals and these kind of places. And when I get this feedback, when people, I see tears in people's eyes, and when they tell me that they are very much touched watching this film, and I feel so elated, because this is very important for an artist, that a subject has been communicated in its true spirit.